introduce me at least. Thank you. Again, our Honorable Secretary is D.S. Dashnanji, and Dr. Tyagi, and Dr. Kajum. And also distinguished audience. I think probably it's a great time. In fact, you know, what great appears to be, you know, that we have the Pargo infrastructure by Minister of Agriculture and also State Agriculture, you know, of course, I mean, the departments of infrastructures. And now the common centers coming in, probably acts as a great complement to infrastructure to take the agriculture through ICT to the farmers in the field. In fact, we have been working at now. I think, in fact, some of the initiatives what we have taken through what a period of decade by various agencies in, you know, in Malaysia, I think there are a number of organizations. In fact, IIT Chennai and the number of organizations have done to bring about various initiatives. In fact, we have studied about, I think, 50 odd initiatives, you know, what are the initiatives throughout India through ICT. And how they play, I mean, we can see some of the positive points and bring them together. So ultimately, we'll be able to probably question one or two unique agriculture portals or agriculture initiatives through which we can really provide the agro services to the farmers. In fact, of course, one of the, you know, I mean, observations that came in, some of the farmers, they may want to have information through, they want access to internet portals, or some of them, they want to go to IVR, they want to pick up a telephone, or they, sometimes, I think, some farmers, they want to send something by SMS, or they want to type in on mobile. I mean, all depends upon what access devices they have, and also what education levels they have. Ultimately, we thought it was important to, I mean, provide whatever way the farmers, they wanted to have the, you know, address services to them. And that's probably we should be able to provide it to them. So we came about something called IADS, in fact, our secretary mentioned earlier, the integrated information system, which really enables the farmers to access whatever the device he has and whatever they want to have. And the other point, probably, I mean, earlier, I think the CEO, Dr. Dinesh Tyagi, mentioned, the farmer is not happy merely by providing the advice on the agro practice alone. And I think probably the most important fact is, you know, he does not want to pay. Historically, farmers are not used to pay for the agro service alone. And we thought, in fact, our experience in the NISA was mentioned quite a few times. And we thought, in fact, we tried very extensively to see whether farmers could really pay in the recent fee. We have tried some deployments in Andhra Pradesh, largely Visa go through some of the companies, some of the NGOs, and some of the organizations. And initially, some farmers have paid, people were extremely happy. And some farmers have paid over a period of time. They say, after you provide the advice to my neighbor, I can pick it up from him. And some people say, you know, advice is supposed to be coming freely from the government of India, and why should we pay? And you know, there are various kinds of the actions. And in fact, you know, some of the cash crops like, you know, in aqua, like, you know, fish and prawns, and people are happy to pay because, no, I mean, they look fish at the prawn dies within a day, they don't get a proper advice. And in fact, we did for one of the NGOs, what we tried in Andhra Pradesh, and people are happy to pay about 1,000 rupees, 15 rupees a crop cycle. I mean, that money was enough to make that operation very sustainable. But that is not really true in crops like, you know, rice and cotton, all of them. So, I mean, then we thought actually how to make the services really sustainable. You know, assuming that we haven't been able to reach the farmer through the Krishigyan Kendra very effectively. I mean, the sand infrastructure is not really enough. Then we thought, I think probably farmers, I mean, through our interactions, they said, we are providing that best fine, but we are not able to get the inputs. You know, we are not able to get the advice and patients what we are advising us. So please also try to see how we can have these inputs. And some people said do not have money to really buy them. So I mean, then we thought actually some kind of integrated approach in terms of the services very much important. Then we came up with a very professionally we engaged the professional organizations. You know, I mean there is some bank and there's some IT company, there's also a digital organization. Three organizations together and we you can take it away. And we studied the, some of the initiatives throughout India, and we came up with a model what we call IASP, Integrated Agri-Services Program. Is it possible to get the computer back? To tell you briefly, because Vidya Vesha into, I mean, providing IT solutions into various areas of common man. We do for level enhancement, family healthcare, employment, disabled, education, spend of time, and the level enhancement into agriculture. And we try to do the technology development also showing the field and really take it to the last deployment with other organizations, that's what we do. And after agriculture, we did a lot of initiatives. In fact, the ESOB has been mentioned already. And EAQR is one that stands for almost all questions answered with the trip to Bombay. And out of that, a startup company has been started called Agrocom. And they are able to provide some advisory. And this one deal is a multimedia platform actually gathering information. In fact, that has grown from IIT Kanpur into Ministry of Agriculture. It is now taken a project called Agropedia. That we're happy that some of the initiatives taken up by Vidya Vesha are actually growing to, they have been accepted by the main stakeholders. And AgroSense, in fact, some of the organizations, I think a number of organizations are trying to see if you can use a wireless sensor that works to really measure the agro parameters from the field. And Vidya Vesha and also CDAC and also many more organizations have some experience in that one. I think probably that kind of potential to really, when you want to go tomorrow for the insurance, at the property, the localized information is very important. Probably then you can drop some of the wireless device and try to gather, the temperature and humidity. And also, we're also trying to see if you can really, take those 5 pH values. And then I can probably, this will help us to really get into other insurance. And we also try to do some community radio. In fact, we installed about 5 community radio stations at technical universities. And we, with the BHU or NSE, we try to do Gramin cameras. In fact, that infrastructure and also other services, people, when you have the infrastructure, it's quite possible to offer various other services. In fact, the farmers are the people who wanted to have various other services also. So we thought what the integration we can do in agriculture. And the IESP is what I was trying to have some few more slides into integrated agri-services program. And the interactive information business system is what you mentioned to really provide the information to the farmer, the way he can ask the query, and also the way we can provide information to him through SMS or through the portal or through phone itself. And we are recently about to launch a mobile-based agro services system for Northeast India. In fact, Secretary would be inaugurating on the coming Saturday in Meghalaya. And some of the observations what we have so far, all the advice gives significant advice to farmers, all of us know. But I think as Dr. Tyagi mentioned, farmers not the right to pay for the advice alone. And and also they are not able to implement they don't have the inputs, they don't have finances, and they don't have the weather, labor, and this one. And I think probably the strategy could be to provide all services in an integrated way. That is what we thought. And some of the services what you can offer are up to the agro advisor, that what is the last we will look at it. And if you can really provide the agro inputs in a way, and there are seeds and fertilizer, fish and insecticide. And either in a way, some we can help them in the procurement and marketing activity. And the local information, and also soil and water testing. In fact, I'm sure Mr. Adil has already started doing that, but I think probably we can go slightly aggressively and the farmer can get soil and better testing done for his rural farm. Then we want the financial services, I think the banking services and the insurance, in fact, are happy to see that, in fact, Mr. Adil and government services are already tied up together to really offer the banking services, and probably we'll be happy to integrate our services with banking services and great. And also, American property, there's other support services, information agriculture equipment, leasing, transport, and storage also. In fact, while we were talking to various the agricultural industry people, they also said, you know, if you can really advise the farmers, you know, what kind of, let's say, tomato, potato is very, is able to fetch high price in India and also abroad, then we can slowly bring them into what I think they're able to bring them higher prices. And if you really provide them the storage mechanism for marketing, probably we'll be able to advise them, you know, what kind of the crops that they're able to grow. And this is what some of the slides. I think probably the opportunity here is if we can, in fact, some of our examples we are trying to see how we can really integrate the common service centers with the Krishuki and Kendras, where the Krishuki and Kendras will be able to provide the advisory, and they will be able to send the advisory, and the common service centers with the VMEs will be able to deliver the advisory to get the data from the farmers, and they will also deliver it. Mechanism. I think probably that's a very valuable mechanism. And in fact, all the time we used to wonder, in fact, how to make it a kind of sustainable agriculture, or how to bring any kind of business into agro advisory. I think probably this is a time now, where you can really operate agriculture in a business way, Probably there's one of the opportunities I think which really excites me through common service centers. And another point which I like to mention is basically what we have done so far. The previously the advice used to be the cross level, broad level, for a village where we can get advice and everything. Or the Kisan call centers are great, a farmer can really speak to expert and take advice. Then we thought, we can really track each and every farmer independently. I think that is a differentiator what we thought so far, what we have done, ReSolve and other products also, and which will open up, I think, many potential opportunities. Suppose you are able to reach all the farmers, you take that the demographic data, they take that soil data and everything. So you have something like a family doctor who knows about patients. So we have the data of the farmer all the time, then the data will be an excellent in providing the advice to him, because when we have the data of the farmer, then what advice you are able to provide to him is a much more efficient than just when somebody is asking you a query, then you have to spend so much of time also with him. When the farmer is asking you, so you have to ask him again and again what the farm and what are the thing and everything. When you have the data already with you, your advice will be excellent. And also, once you have the advice, after 2 weeks or 3 months, advice after 1 month, so you have the series of the time, time series of the previous information, I think probably that could will be very valuable in providing advice to the farmer. And then you look at the opportunities in insurance and the banking services. I think banks would naturally require information of the farmer, to really extend the this one private service to them. Once we have the data of the banks, farmers already, probably that the banks would not mind to pay some service fee to commerce service centers. Probably that what excites me how to really make this delivery of the services to the VMEs or commerce service centers, I think, exciting. And in fact, the input providers. When VLE or common service center has the data, what kind of crop a farmer is growing, and suppose in a village, this paddy or the wheat is grown by particular farmers, the treatment is already available, and what stage crop is also available, because you are providing advice. That information will be very handy for really making the input providers to reach the farmer. So that's what, in fact, our ISP, whatever we call the agriculture program, this information will be, very useful to make it financially sustainable. In fact, we have that report available. We will explore further with Thomas and SPV to really implement to at least some pockets throughout India and how to scale it up. And another point which I'd like to say, in fact, out of information, farmers portal by Minister of Agriculture also has information available. And in fact, we have spoken to most of them, and we are actually trying to see how we can really bring it together. When the agriculture scientist is providing advice to the farmer, when he has all the information, that will be very valuable to him. And apart from agriculture, we already started implementing some of the other services to common service centers. They are into some livelihood. We have some embroidery software. In fact, the Osama Manjar is here. We did with him, from the 3 years, we did with him a deployment project in MP, Madhya Pradesh, in the embroidery, which is very successful. Collaboration with BF and Russia, and we are also trying to do some kind of similar collaboration with the common set of the centers in the agriculture and also other areas like the livelihood and also the healthcare. And and in fact, I request Dr. Sanjeev Gupta, really in how to integrate some of the initiatives that are taken by them already. I think but other day we'll work with another Joint Secretary, Dr. Poshan, and he was very much interested in how to really extend the market services through the IESP or the IADS kind of structure. When we have the farmers' access and we have the data, and how we can really provide them the marketing information directly. And the effects, I think, we wanted to discuss with you separately and the other sense intensely how to really integrate some of these initiatives to really take the moment in a much more forward way. And I think that's all I have for time. Thank you very much for your attention.